Hello and welcome to the episode 44 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we will cover a new chance, a trip to Miami, and a launch party, among other things. On the 30th of February 1962 in London, manager Brian Epstein met for the first time George Martin, head of A&R of Parlophone Records. Martin came across as witty and approachable, a markedly different figure compared to the other A&R people Epstein had met before. On hearing the demo recordings that Epstein had cut from the rejected Decca audition, Martin expressed interest in the Beatles. While not over-impressed, he felt that the band had certain qualities that deserved further investigation. In particular, it seems Martin enjoyed the band's performance of Hello Little Girl, Until There Was You, George Harrison's guitar playing, and Paul McCartney vocal performances, identifying him as a possible band leader. As a result, he agreed to audition the band personally, despite not being able to set a definite date for the affair. Epstein left Martin's office in a rather happy mood, though. Finally, another breakthrough after the Decca fiasco. Meanwhile, further up north, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. In 1963, the Beatles were on stage at the Majestic Ballroom in Hull. In 1964, the Beatles flew from New York City to Miami, Florida, to record their second live appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show. Landing at 4 p.m., the Fabs were welcomed by 7,000 fans and reached their rooms at the Deauville Hotel, escorted by the police. Fun fact, the Beatles were accompanied by superfan DJ Murray the K from New York, who talked the band into allowing him to be with them for the whole trip and to share a room with George Harrison. On the 30th of February 1967, the Beatles were at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road for more work on their upcoming album. After four mono mixes of A Day in the Life were completed, to serve as a reference on the work done so far on the song, the focus turned to a George Harrison number, temporarily called Not Known. The band recorded nine takes of the rhythm track of what would have become Only a Northern Song. The piece was meant to be George's contribution to Sgt. Pepper's and, at the moment, featured George on organ, Paul on bass, John on tambourine and Ringo on drums. As we will see, the band kept working on the song, but it remained unreleased until January 1969 though, gracing the Yellow Submarine original soundtrack album. The session, having started at 7 p.m., was wrapped up at 3:30 a.m. Finally, in 1969, Paul McCartney took part to the Apple Records party for the launch of Mary Hopkins' album Postcard. The party included a number of music VIPs as guests, including Jimi Hendrix, Donovan, Eric Clapton, and Brian Jones, but Paul was the special guest, so to speak. Not only he was, naturally, one of the main forces within Apple, but he had been instrumental in the signing of Hopkins to the label, and he had produced all of her releases so far. This party concludes today's episode of What a Fab Day. Please remember checking out www.simonmas.com/support if you'd like to know how you can help me to produce the best material I can. In the episode description, you will find a link to the bibliography of the podcast with its Amazon affiliate links. Please consider making your Beatles-related shopping through them. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.